is the Toyota Land Cruiser. Now, Toyota have already tried to break into the four-wheel drive market in this country with another vehicle called a Land Cruiser that they marketed a few years ago with a distinct lack of success. Now they're back with this diesel-engine Land Cruiser. It's a new model with a very nice wagon body and an awful lot of room inside. This Land Cruiser is only available as a diesel engine version, and the company claimed that this gives it a significant economy advantage over, say, the Range Rover, without sacrificing anything in performance across country. One of the main complaints about the old model of the Land Cruiser was that it had a bone-shaking ride, very, very strong kart springs that really jolted you over every hump and bump in the track. Now, that's all right in a utility vehicle like the Land Rover, but estate passengers are surely looking for a little bit more comfort than that. So it was a surprise to find that this new model of the Land Cruiser still retained this very traditional way of suspending cross-country vehicles. However, the vehicle is very well equipped. It comes with the legendary Japanese levels of reliability and engineering quality built in, and it's at a very competitive price. It'll be interesting to see how it fares in the marketplace, because it seems to be aimed very much at the segment of the market that the Jeep vehicles were looking at, and they failed noticeably to put any sort of dent in the British market. But the more time you spend bombing around cross-country tracks like this, the more you come to the conclusion that perhaps by accident Land Rover engineers came up with quite a superb vehicle when they engineered the old Range Rover. It's been around for over 10 years now, and really there's very few of these new cross-country vehicles that can hold a candle to it, perhaps with the possible exception of that very expensive Mercedes G-Wagon.